Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. As the chairman of the Institute of National Security Studies, I consider this as a great pride and a privilege to address this gathering of the annual memorial lecture conducted by the INSS with the dual aims of commemorating the war heroes of Sri Lanka while providing the opportunity for the future generations to learn and study about the great military strategists and war heroes, those who have ever existed in this country. This endeavor initiated by the INSS is intended to share the knowledge required to instill strategic thinking and to build professionalism among the future military leaders of Sri Lanka. Ladies and gentlemen, for your information, this memorial lecture, which is about to commence, stands as the fourth lecture among a series of lectures arranged and conducted by INSS. This series of orations were initiated in year 2017 to commemorate the great characters of Lieutenant General Denzil Kobbe Kadua, followed by the second in 2018 on late Major General Vijay Vimal Ratna, and the third on Colonel Fasil Lafir in year 2019. This memorial lecture on Admiral Clancy Fernando was planned to be held last year, as mentioned by our Admiral. However, we could not materialize the same last year owing to the pandemic situation right around the country. Amidst the continuation of the pandemic, we decided to conduct this event without making any further delays. Accordingly, today we will be able to listen to an oration of a man of great legacy, late Admiral Clancy Fernando, VSV, NDC, PSC, a role model of a great heroic military leader of our time, under the theme of Sea Power of an Island Nation and Admiral Clancy Fernando. Ladies and gentlemen, I still remember the day he was killed in action. I was a young major serving in Army headquarters, and I was given with a Suzuki Maruti Jeep, Gypsy. So I was in my Jeep with the Slave Island railway gate, and train was passing, and I saw a naval motorcade passing my vehicle, and I realized that it was the then Navy commander. So they were in a hurry to move, and the moment the gate was opened, it rushed, and I also started my journey slowly, and within 2 minutes I heard the explosion, and I also rushed to the location, and it was a very sad and pathetic scene, and I saw Madam Fernando also rushing into the place, and it was one of the saddest occasions during my whole military career to see a service commander just killed in action by a brutal terrorist organization. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, having born in year 1938, Admiral Clancy Fernando has enlisted as an officer cadet in the Royal Ceylon Navy in year 1957 and proceeded for advanced training at the Britannia Royal Navy College in Dartmouth, United Kingdom. Since the beginning of his career as an officer cadet until he became the commander of the Navy, who commanded the Sri Lankan Navy from 1st November 1991 to 16th November 1992, he has displayed sheer dedication, commitment, bravery and loyalty to the motherland in an exemplary manner. His commitment during Operation Balavega alongside General Denzil Kobbe Kadua to land troops at Vettilaikerni, which was the single largest operation ever undertaken by the Sri Lankan Navy in that magnitude, is highly commendable. Further, the progression he has pioneered in the Sri Lankan Navy within his whole service to the nation, and especially during his tenure as the commander of the Navy, to ensure the sovereignty of our beloved motherland, thus stand praiseworthy. However, the country had to bear the sad demise of Admiral Clancy Fernando in the year 1992, as he was assassinated by the brutal terrorist organization LTTE, and he is known to be the most senior officer in the Sri Lankan military to be killed in action in the line of duty towards the motherland. I firmly believe that this session would allow us the prospect of deeply understanding his character, whilst offering the opportunity for our younger generations to expose themselves to his achievements and the absolute bravery displayed by him, which is a perfect blend of tenacity and perseverance that would assist our new generations to mold their careers towards a clear, professionally vibrant future. Furthermore, This opportunity will also allow his beloved wife and the family members of late Admiral Clancy Fernando to call back their past memories and to feel proud of him as a war hero who has extended a highly commendable, trustworthy service to the nation, to the motherland, and to its people. Ladies and gentlemen, as citizens of this proud island nation, we all must wholeheartedly endure and appraise that the defeat of LTT was the result of dedication, commitment, hard work, and ultimate sacrifice of fallen and living war heroes. Great patriotism displayed by our war heroes from the history to date led the citizens of Sri Lanka in yearning peace and harmony for decades. Accordingly, remembering and honoring the selfless acts of fallen war heroes, such as Admiral Clancy Fernando's contribution that he has made for the betterment of the future generation of the country, is a noble gesture that we can offer to such martyrs of the country. Ladies and gentlemen, our guest speaker today, my senior Admiral Thisara Samarasinghe, 16th Commander of the Sri Lanka Navy, is undoubtedly the most fitting personality to deliver the memorial oration of late Admiral Clancy Fernando. Being an exceptionally qualified, renowned professional with remarkable virtues of perseverance, coupled with brilliant know-how in the field of maritime culture, along with experience he has gained in working in line with late Admiral Clancy Fernando, would absolutely be profitable for all of us. Therefore, I consider it as a privilege to listen to Admiral Thisara Samarasinghe today. With that thought in mind, ladies and gentlemen, finally let me extend my heartfelt gratitude to Admiral Thisara Samarasinghe for taking time off his busy schedule for attending this event to share his thoughts with us. Further, I should thank the Secretary, Foreign Ministry, the Director General of INSS and his staff for organizing this event amidst the restrictions imposed by COVID-19 pandemic. With utmost respect, I must also admire and honor the beloved wife of late Admiral Clancy Fernando, Madam Monica Fernando, and all the family members of his family and close relatives for their gracious presence here with us today. And finally, thank you very much and wishing you a pleasant and fruitful evening, and also a great lecture from Admiral Thisara Samarasinghe. Thank you very much.